Good morning again, everyone. My name is Jillian. I just want to thank God for His goodness. I want to thank God for His mercy this morning. And I want to thank the prophet for the privilege to testify this morning. The past 16 years, 17 years, I've been in a situation like I was having some problems. I went to different churches. Didn't know what was happening to me. We couldn't have no peace in the house. This is my daughter over there. No peace. Like fighting and cussing and all different things was going on in the house. Didn't know what was the problem. I went to churches. I remember I went to South Africa. I have my passport. I just want to show you something. I remember the way how I was so desperate. Sorry for just being a little bit nervous. I remember going to South Africa, but this is my visa for Nigeria. I wanted to see TD Joshua, so this is my visa that I went to Jamaica to get, because I was in Trinidad here and I searched all different churches just to get one deliverance. But by getting to Nigeria, it was a little bit difficult. So I asked the agency to, you know, book me for a flight to South Africa. So I have the here, somebody could just look this here. I stand there for South Africa. So I went to South Africa in 2019. I stamp is there for South Africa. So when I went there to see Pastor Africa, I didn't get through. I will just tell you one of the things that this strong man did to me. While I was in the hotel after visiting the church in the morning, I didn't get through because these pastors, you know, a lot of people, thousands of people. So one of the time I was trying to walk into him and, you know, bodyguards and everything, because I was so desperate for this deliverance. And I remember while going back to the hotel, I was there sleeping and I feel like an earthquake shaking the hotel, shaking on the place. So, you know, it was a dormitory room, you know, more than one people there. So I look around and I see a lady there. So I say, you feel an earthquake? She said, no. So I thought I was, you know, she was joking. So I went back to sleep, and the same thing happened. And you know, this demon was just doing so many things. I couldn't ask her again because it would look like, you know, I was crazy. So I just went away, and there's something to eat. Anyway, coming back to Trinidad, I went to another church over and over. And I remember the man of God there, you know, he touched me, and that spirit manifested, and nothing happened. When I went home, trouble in the house. You know, it's like you just, you know, touch it and then it's get out of hand again. And you see my children fighting with each other. There's no peace right through. So, last week, I booked a flight for the 15th. I have a ticket here. This is my ticket to St. Vincent. I booked for the 15th of September, coming back on the 22nd of September. Because somebody, you know, my son was a friend with a lady that came to this church. And, you know, my son was talking to her. And she said, Mommy, I have a friend online. You want to talk to her? So I said, yeah, no problem. And I said to her, you know, I want to travel out there. I want to, you know, go into a church next week. And she said, well, we have a prophet in San Fernando. I said, yes. I said, send the videos to me. Let me look and see what is going on. So when I look at the video, I said, well, this is over. I know it's over because just looking at the man, I know that my deliverance is right here. So I said to her, I'm canceling the flight. Without reaching here, I just tell her, I'm going to cancel the flight. So when I came here Sunday, I don't know if anybody was here. Yeah. I know some of you was here, so you know, it's a witness. So when I was here, I was feeling, you know, something started to happen to me. Just to see the man of God, things started to happen and I just keep quiet. So when it was time for us, for people to be prayed for, I was the first one that reached, you know. Because over and over I've been praying for this, praying, sleepless nights. Right now this strong man, that strong man caused one of my sons right now to be in jail for nothing at all. So it's just like death over my family, my daughter when she's not sick, and it's all gone. So when I came here, you know, it was starting to happen. You know, I could feel it, but I tried to hold it up. So when I came to the altar, I was standing in front of the prophet. I started to feel things already start to want to go. So when he touched me in my head, I know he started to manifest. And I could say today that I am delivered. But one thing I want to say to you people that who are here, you are so blessed to have a prophet in this nation. I had to go to South Africa. It takes me about 20 hours up in the air. It wasn't nice. Eh? It wasn't so comfortable either. And didn't get through. In Trinidad here, didn't get through more than one time. I see that prophet touching people, and there was on the ground manifesting, seeing it moving all over. And everybody get it up and go home the same. So I was saying to God, God, why is it that people manifesting and I'm seeing a deliverance? All the time does be happening. Even with me, it happened, it manifests, and I go home with the same thing. But I want to say something to you. It's Acts 3, because the Spirit of God told me to say this. It's Acts 3, verse 1 to 19. Because it was this story about this man that was crippled from birth. Alright? There was a church, you know, where they brought this man to the gate called Beautiful. And all these people was going into this church. You know, nothing was going on. They passed him, nobody laid hands on him, because they might be thinking that the problem, you know, couldn't be solved, you know, because he was born that way. So God allowed Peter and John to be passing that way. I didn't see in the Bible where it said that Peter and John was living around there. I was going to that church. I don't know if I made a mistake there.
Yes.
But I want to say to you, God has taken this prophet from somewhere and brought him in this land of Trinidad and Tobago for my reason. I can't say for nobody else, just to deliver me. Because God used Peter and John because they was carrying a different anointing. And when I look at that scripture verse, I say, well, the anointing that this Peter and John was carrying, it's the same thing our prophet here is carrying. Because I'm searching and I see prophet touches me in my head and demon manifests and it didn't came out. But just one touch from the man. And if God should remove his spirit out of the man of God, the man would kill him. So just that to tell you that there's something. God, the healer is in this man, the deliverer in this man. I don't know about you. I know what I've been through. So I can testify about this man of God. I don't know him from nowhere. I haven't seen him but the first time here, last week Sunday. So I want to say to you with this Bible verse that God took him from somewhere to Trinidad and Tobago for some difficult matters, because there are some people that cannot handle some problems. And God anointed some people for difficult matters, some sickness that cannot be healed. And you will have a pastor this time. You're not coming against nobody, eh? Excuse me. You have some, you know, we'll hover for a hour, 2 hours, and don't say anything in the name of Jesus and nothing happened. But Peter and John, just by saying to the man, look at him and say, in the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise and walk. The Bible says immediately, handled, restore, everything was normal. And those same people in the church, God allowed that man to go into the church, rejoicing and singing and giving praise. And the people that was in that church started to give problem. They started to come to Peter and John and ask him, how comes? There wasn't helping the man to rejoice over his deliverance. Yeah. Instead, they was making trouble. And Peter then said to them, all you need to go and repent. It's not of our holiness. It's not of his holiness while I receive my deliverance. But it's because of the God, oh hallelujah, that is living on the inside of this prophet. So I want to tell you people, just a small amount of you, but take good care of this man of God. Because prophets of this, prophet is like this one, is in high demand. I don't know if anybody know what I mean when I say that. They have to find. So let us keep on praying for it. All right? Don't watch how you while they're moving, you know? Just keep on praying for it. Amen? God bless you all. Thank you.